Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. Each week of this podcast, we cover another 3D modeling tool inside of Cinema 4D. And today's 3D modeling tool is normal scale. This is actually a remake of episode 2 because I noticed that there were some small changes to that tool and I didn't want anyone to get confused watching the old video, so I thought I should update it. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and show how normal scale works. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D. Right now I have garage shading lines turned on so that when I add in segments, I can see them more easily. Over here, I can hold down and click on this cube, and in our primitive drop-down menu, I can click on this plane here in order to add it to our scene. I'm going to keep our width segments 10, height segments 10 as well, and that's good to go. When I click this button here, it will make this plane editable so that we can adjust the mesh. And I'll change it from being a primitive to being editable. So there we go, we have our editable plane. And I'm going to make sure that I'm in polygon mode, and you do that by clicking here because this tool only works in polygon mode. And with that done, we can select some polygons here to use this tool on. The hotkey for normal scale is M hyphen, so I'll go ahead and hit that button there. M hyphen, and now we have normal scale. And actually, if you'd like to see a list of hotkeys, if you just click M, you'll see them all listed here for a moment, and then you'll see normal scale has a hyphen next to it. So that's how you know that's the hotkey for it. And you can see it in our attribute manager. You can adjust your scale here within your options. And you'll see we have real-time update turned on. I think it's always good to leave real-time update on. It'll just let you see your changes in real-time, which is good. And then there's this button down here, apply. It'll apply the transformation of scale, and new transformation will apply another additional transformation to that area. You'll notice that one button is no longer here. There used to be a button here that said reset values, and it's been removed from the user interface in the newer update. So if you want to undo a transformation you've done, instead of using reset values, just use Control Z for undo on a PC or Command Z on a Mac to undo your transformation. So if your screen looks a little bit different, you might be in a different version of Cinema 4D. I have the most up-to-date version you can see here, 2023.2.2. And I'll go ahead and drag my mouse in order to apply the transformation. And you can see that the scale is updating in the attribute manager as I drag my mouse. I'm adjusting the scale. So I'll scale it, let's say 50%. And you can also adjust the value in here by just typing it in, which is sometimes easier than just holding down your mouse and moving it back and forth. And with that done, let's say this is going to be a skyscraper just for fun. I'll hold down Control and we're in. You can see that we have these arrows here and they allow us to move. And if you hold down Control, it'll extrude. So now we have an extrusion. This is a skyscraper. If you want to apply the transformation again, you can hit new transformation and apply that, scale this 50% to that top portion there. If you want to scale it again, you could even hit that button again, and now it scaled it in another 50% from what it was before. So you have those kinds of abilities to continue to scale it down if you'd like to. even after by hitting that new transformation button. I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial and will find it helpful. Normal scale is a great tool for scaling polygons within your scene accurately because you can enter in exact dimensions within the attribute manager. And if you enjoyed this tutorial and you'd like to learn more 3D modeling tools, please hit like or subscribe so that you're notified the next time a tutorial comes out. And thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next Wednesday on Ambient 3D Animations.